It's an art form that has been practiced for thousands of years. But for one man, glass blowing is more than art. It's a passion.
I got into glass blowing because I absolutely fell in love with it, and I dedicated my whole life to glass.
And now that passion has turned into a thriving business called John Pomp Studios in downtown Philadelphia, where they hand blow glass to make handcrafted, one-of-a-kind lighting and furniture.
Glass is nothing without light, right? So when you have a vase, and I've been making vases all these years, you know, it's only beautiful when the light is just right. But when we create a piece of lighting, we control our light source, and so it's always beautiful. A lot of the designs come from process. And because I'm a glass maker of 20 years, my intimacy with the material and processes are very specific, so I have a very unique perspective.
And that unique perspective has made John Pomp Studios one of the fastest growing companies in the U.S., with a 592% growth rate over the past 3 years.
We have approximately, I think, around 20,000 square feet now, and we're kind of scouting for more space to anticipate the years to come, but it's growing. We need more space.
It's a good problem to have.
It is. It's a great problem to have.
To what does he attribute his success?
So I think it's everything that you don't see from the outside. I think people look in and you're like, oh, you have this, you have that, but they don't see the 10, 20 years of undying determination and sacrifice or struggling to pay the bills or what have you, or reinvesting in the company. It's really all the blood, sweat, and tears that come into it. I've always said that I was able to apply my discipline of my craft to my business, to organization, to systems, to money. When you spend your time and becoming very proficient at something, at, you know, for me it was glass blowing, and to like master glass blowing, you're able to take those attributes and reapply them in other ways to the business. That's how it all comes together, for me at least.
And he says it's all about the quality of the craft.
We literally make everything from scratch. We process all of our own wood, metal, and glass, and you know, that's very unique. I think we're also in the business age of subcontracting and farming things out to different shops, and we put things together, and you know, that's okay, but I get to have the control and the quality that they can't have. What drives me? Creativity. Being able to keep inspired, keep creating new ways of making new things. I always said that I don't want to make anything unless I want to live with it and really live with it and love it so much. And so that's what we do.
Holly Firfer, CNN, Philadelphia.